coaching. That's right guard, a senior from Scandinavia, Wisconsin, 56, Gary Villano. That's right tackle, a senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 77, Lawrence Wayne. That wide receiver from Chicago, Illinois, number 89, Larry Fletcher. And another receiver, number 80, from Oshkosh, Pete Greeninger. At quarterback, sophomore from Pulaski, Wisconsin, 18, Dennis Rubas. At fullback, a sophomore from Greenfield, Wisconsin, number 31, Chris Kujawa. And at halfback, a senior from Green Bay, number 34, Mike Matsky, and the Titans of Oshkosh. And now we're introducing the starting defensive lineup of the Falcons of River Falls, coached by Joe McCoy. Ball carried by Matsky.
Yeah. Keep your eyes off of it! Look for it! Look for it!
by Semler. Tackled by Walker.
Thank you.
by Carson Hopkins. First down, Oshkosh. Ball carried by Jawa.
Timeout, How tall is he?
Come on, guys, tight!
that or don't throw out of the shotgun. A game, save him time.
Yeah! Boy, that was a gutsy call.
Yeah. How you doing?
Yeah.
3-yard gain on the play.
Score on this one. That was a big play.
Thank you.
Where the heck was that ref spotting the ball? Bet you they run it on this side. That off tackle thing where Gary pulls out here.
Come on. And number 44, Mike Bright. And number 95, Andy Brzezinski on the tackle. Gain of one.
Yeah.
Bryce and Jarrett Sola on the tackle. We have official timeout for America.
Gare! Hoskin.
Complete drill. We have a flag.
Oh, is that right? Yeah, we've damn mistakes again.
76, I got lost. Snap, John. John had a mess on it. He never got close.
Broken up by Landfelder.
This is never got close that time. Third and 10 and punt.
Third down,
M-10
from the
20. Their PA system is too long.
Jeez. Come on, you guys.
Men in motion, right side. He's over the line of scrimmage.
Complete Durrell.
Let's get the enthusiasm back!
Yep. Yeah. Running
right at you. Nothing fancy, nothing, just keep going.
Yep. That's right. They could have been beat. A little wide open in a... Yeah, we should have been up about...
Fourth downs we should have been going for in the first half.
Why not? Your season's screwed up anyway. Yeah. Just let her go. Let her hang out. Jeez. Oh, jeez. Bunch of crap.
Nice catch.
Got it, didn't he?
No.
Nope. Well, that's the truth.
Ricardo, she's putting his team in this predicament always. Get him so far in a hole.
Yeah, I know.
You get a pass and everything.
Yep.
You have no options.
Just start gunning for you. Gunning for the receivers.
A lot of talent in this football team.
You bet. Well coached.
Ball is on the 31. Big deal, yeah.
Now you're really nothing. I didn't think before you could either.
Touchdown, Christian.
Give it the Cujo. I know what play they're going to run. Right. You're going to come to this side. Right guard's going to pull. We're going to send Cujo over on this side. No.
No.
Oh, he dropped it, huh?
It was right there.
Intended for somewhere.
Time.
It's still snowing.
Yeah. Good kid, good kid. Sure, take him. Yeah! Your mother wants you to be a hit at the end.
Yeah. Cronin thing.
You got the blanket?
Yeah. You got 16 blankets on the
Thank you.
Until we get done with, get through with all of them. Lonnie's been a four-year player here, actually a five-year player. He took off 1 year and got himself going in the classroom, and it was really beneficial to him because he was struggling a little bit there at the start, and when he came back, he's been over to 3-point ever since. And I have to give him a lot of credit for making the decision to do that. Not many people would make that decision, but Lonnie's as concerned about getting his education as he is about playing football. He's done a great job for us over the years as a linebacker. He's from Green Bay, Wisconsin. Depere, Wisconsin, excuse me. Steve Budick is from Illinois, came to us through the junior colleges, struggled a little bit at the start trying to find a position. We've had him playing on offense and defense and back and forth, and finally this year he's come through towards the end of the year here, and has got Matsky is the third all-time leading rusher in Titan history. He would have been number one if it weren't for our transition from the Veer offense to throwing the football. I have to give him an awful lot of credit because a lot of people would have thought more about themselves and getting some things accomplished as far as records and personal records, but Mark wasn't that way at all. He's been a team man for us all year long, and he's one of the hardest workers that I've ever coached. You never have to tell Mark to do one thing or another. He's always going to be the first one there to do it or suggest to do more. And it's been a real pleasure for me to work with Mark over the years that he's been here. Brian Rill. Brian started out here in our program as a Veer quarterback, and he was our starting quarterback. He did a great job for us. Last year, we had him working out at quarterback, and we started the season with him. Dennis Bogots came through and had a great season, and Brian never ended up falling back into the quarterback position. I thought that he was as good an athlete as we've ever had in our program, and I felt that we had to have him somewhere on the football field. We ended up putting him as a wide receiver, or as a receiver. He kind of played the different spots as far as our spread team goes and our regular offense, and he's really produced. He's done an outstanding job over the years. He's gained enough recognition where he got a broken hand. He broke his hand on the first play of the game and played the entire game with it. And today he came back, we devised a cast where we could get it on his hand and cover it so he could still play. This is the first week that he came back and is back for us, but we're going to miss John in our football program here. Paul Donert.
Donert!
Paul's from Green Bay, Wisconsin. He's been in this program as well for 4 years. He plays free safety, well, actually five. That's right, because he was redshirted a year. And, you know, I can remember Paul's junior year. He lettered for us as a sophomore. And his junior year, he could have, he ended up back on the scout team because we had some people that came in and were doing a fine job for us. And Paul was in a position, being a junior, going back to the scout team where he could have quit. Instead, he just continued to fight back. He was on the scout team and he was really working hard. I had the opportunity to come back against Platteville when Todd Schozo went down for us last year and came up with a big interception at the end of the game for us to ice that game when they were threatening to take the to score a touchdown to take the lead in that football game. But he's been an outstanding person in our program. He's a real team player, and we're going to miss that out of Paul. And Brad is a very well-liked individual, as you can see here. Brad's an offensive tackle who's played in the program for 4 years. Really developed the last couple of years. He's also a heavyweight wrestler on the wrestling team, and he feeds our football team with cheese curds. We're going to miss Brad because he's always got a smiling face. Gary Velno, he doesn't always have a smiling face. Gary is a very intense person, whether it be on the playing field or the practice field. And, you know, he's always going to give 100%, and he hurt his knee midway through the season here and has had some real problems trying to struggle through practice day in and day out. But he's always been out there for us, and he's always never misses practice, and he's always given 100%. He's had a great season for us this year at offensive guard, and it has made a big difference in our offense for us. And I want to mention one other thing. Where is the Vilno clan? Where is that Vilno clan? Raise your hands. I'll tell you. You talk about support and people who are... they've been all over for 4 years, and they have been really a great backer, not only for Gary, but for this whole football team.
Hey, yeah.
Pete Greeninger. Pete is from Oshkosh here. He's a wide receiver for us. He's been... not so productive the first 2 years, and I know that the first 2 years he was really struggling with me, and it's not because he wasn't capable of it. It was because we threw the ball about 3 to 7 times a game. And we've come back now the last 2 years, and we've thrown the ball quite a bit, and Pete has been a big factor in our offense. He's come up with big plays, and he comes through with the catch over the middle. And he's done an awful lot of things for our football program, and we're going to miss him here. John Stack. Not only is John a very popular person, but he is a real class individual. I'll tell you, I got a lot of respect for John.
Where's that?
He was a quarterback for us that we recruited for the Vera offense. We brought him in here, and his sophomore year against Whitewater, Brian went down. He played behind Brian at quarterback for the first 2 years. Brian went down. We went down to Whitewater, and Whitewater was ranked in the country. All they had to do was beat us on Saturday to get by. To win the Wisconsin state title and to go to the playoffs. And John came in and filled in and played a great game. And that afternoon we beat Whitewater 21-3. a great leader. He is a great leader. And he's as fine a young man as I've ever been associated with and coached. He's done our kicking chores in that for us. And he's an outstanding leader on our team. And I'm going to miss him. And I know that this whole football program is going to miss him. And our university is going to miss him because he's a class individual.